So the photo is UgandaCrops.com. So it's my honor to launch this, and I wish you all the best and growth in numbers in terms of sales, starting from today. What time is it? At 3:30. Thank you so much.
The ongoing Arts and Crafts Expo is one of the initiatives by the National Arts and Cultural Crafts Association of Uganda, NACAU, and the Ministry of Tourism, aimed at promoting local tourism. Speaking at the expo, State Minister for Tourism, Martin Mugaraba Hinduka, pledged support to the arts and crafts sector, which employs thousands of Ugandans.
I was walking around. You know, this is a product. First of all, a lot of passion from all the participants that come up with this product that you see here today. But of course, the mobilization of communities to participate and the empowerment component that it comes with, because women are involved and so much. So I have to thank the government partners that have been a part of this. I know some that are not even here, like Enebo, that has been supporting in terms of skilling. But I think now the argument should be, I think we've done some good skilling, PSFU. So now the argument is, how do we get these products in the market so that we can create some revenue for these people? And I can assure you, I think the market would be there. The problem is still the awareness.
Mugara further noted that with the onset of a COVID-19 pandemic that battered the entire world so hard, it is high time that the tourism sector turns to the domestic market, noting that as the foreign markets slowly return, the local market can serve as the magic bullet for tourism.
10% of the people participating within the tourism sector are the Ugandans, and they are paying a lot of money, even on the back end. Some of them are even paying $300 to sleep in these expensive hotels, $150. So we have a big market as if we targeted the Ugandans alone. And of course, I think we shall focus on this as well. That not on the market is a Muzungu who comes here and maybe buys one or two items. Let's focus on this young population that we have in Uganda that is earning some small money. These products are not so expensive.
At the same event, an e-commerce platform under the name Craft Shop Uganda was launched. The platform will be used for buyers to view and also buy the different Ugandan arts and culture products.
Also more interested in the story of the item. And that's why we are actually catering for, say, we take the time to identify what the raw materials are, what the district of origin is.
The Uganda Tourism Association President Herbert Weirhanga urged National Arts and Cultural Crafts Association to ensure the members are skilled.
If we have got more paying clients coming to our country, it's automatic that the domestic will grow. I've been in this for some time, I know it very well. But also as a matter of fact, if you look at our national partner minister, a foreign tourist pays $40, a Ugandan pays 20. So you need 7 Ugandans to create 1 foreign tourist. And if the truth is that when you enter our national parks, if you get 200 Ugandans entering national parks, I can tell you comfortably that you need to follow them with a pickup to collect garbage. And that's something you must be sensitive about.
The knowledge of online marketing. NACAU is proposed to pay grand rent to the Uganda National Cultural Center, and because of the COVID-19 lockdown, there is very limited business and NACAU members cannot meet the obligations for rent.
According to NACAU, this is the first Ugandan Arts and Culture Crafts Expo, and it will showcase the different products that they offer, but also show how art can be used to preserve culture and heritage. Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.